Hello everyone, my name is SiC and welcome to a new series for XCOM 2, where we will be playing with the Long War 2 mod. Now, if you were watching my XCOM 2 videos before, I'm sorry, that series is now ended because it wasn't really being watched all that much, and I wasn't doing all too well, to be honest. So I hope that with a new start, as well as a new mod in the mix, interest will go up and I will do a lot better this time around. So, Long War 2 adds a lot of new things, basically to the strategic layer of the game that wasn't there before, but some of the things that they added we already know from my last playthrough as well, where we have like the extra leader perks, we have the laser rifles, we have extra aliens. All of that stuff is still here in the game. This time around, however, we also have extra advantages or extra stuff added to the strategic layer that I don't know all that much about, and we are going to have to figure out as we go along. And we have a new soldier class that we can play called a technical, and we also have a new weapon tier for, I think they're called coil rifles. So there's a lot of new things going on in this game, and I figured the best way to get about it is just getting started on it. Let's see, let's just click for Long War. We will be playing on Commander difficulty. Let's see, Long War options may be set in an option menu after the campaign begins. This tutorial will not be enabled, or the tutorial will not be enabled with this mod. Okay, that's perfectly fine. I don't really want that. I can reduce beginner VO. This is the general tutorial. I'm not going to be playing that, of course. So let's see, Commander difficulty will be fine. Let's click on next. In Iron Man, of course, we will be playing Iron Man. We will activate the optional narrative content as well. Accept that. And I'm just going to go watch through the cutscene again. Continues to build as city centers across the globe prepare for the 20th anniversary of Unification Day.
Thousands line up at the site of the Great Accord, celebrating the formation of the Advent Coalition.
Keeping with their promise to humanity, 12 new gene therapy clinics will be opening in select cities by the end of the new year.
Despite the attempted attack by fringe elements, operations at the new facility in Paris thankfully remain unaffected.
In response to the unprovoked intrusion on the eve of our most beloved celebration, the speaker reaches out to us.
A small number of dissidents again repeat the mistakes of the old world.
Striking as we celebrate the benevolent savior of time and again offers only friendship and compassion.
Yet these trivial actions could never break the bond between humanity and the Elders.
Peacekeeping forces have already made several preemptive arrests of known collaborators. Advent again assures all citizens that today's celebrations will continue as planned.
Approaching position. You were right. Definitely got their hands full today.
Stay focused. Prep Gatecrasher.
60 seconds.
Man, do I love me that intro. Well, Well, that's something new. We have a new loading screen. Let's see. Operation Gatecrasher. Ambush in Advent Troop Column. Alright. That is something that is definitely new. It's not the same as the original Operation Gatecrasher. That's great, because I played the original Operation Gatecrasher so many times, I'm kind of sick of it. So I'm curious to see what this mission will be like. Alright, so we're ready. Loading took a little while. For some reason, yeah. Alright, so we have a new mission, our new Operation Gatecrasher, and we have to ambush enemy troops. And that's kind of similar, I guess, to the original Operation Gatecrasher, where we had to ambush some more troops as well. Like, that was the initiation of the conflict. I guess this will be sort of the same function, but this time around the mission will be different. So all we need to do is neutralize all enemy targets, and we have a lot of soldiers here, it's crazy. Anyway, let's see. Advent typically moves its forces in large groups, but we have located a smaller unit on its own that is vulnerable. A well-timed assault will damage Advent's interests in this region and afford us a rare opportunity to bring home enemy corpses for research. Alright.
Squad concealment active.
Wow. That is a lot of people. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 people compared to the original 4 people that we had in the base game. That's absolutely crazy, isn't it? Right, so we are, well, the map stretches off a little bit in either direction by the looks of it. We are sort of, oh, okay, we are in the top left around here, so that's fine. I think what we'll want to do is move up to this house over here. Maybe possibly move through it, but let's see. Our first character, Yvonne Sanchez, can move up to light cover over here. See if she can see anything more than we can at the moment, and apparently, no. Alright, so let's move you up into high cover by the wall and have a look inside the house. Nothing still. And then we have Ben Snyder. All right, let's see, let's move you up next to the door. Yes, sir. Along with somebody else. Oh, that's me, I'm back in the game. Excellent. All right, so I'm going to be going through the house as well. I am wearing Titanfall gear, so that's another one of the mods that I'm still running, is like extra cosmetic stuff and a few mods as well for this stuff. Let's see, throw frag grenade, throw flashbang grenade. Don't know why this is black. Maybe one of the mods is interfering with new icons for Long War, maybe? I don't know. Not sure why they would want to change the icons if they did, so probably not. Might just be a random bug. Right, then we have one of my other favorite characters that I created. Let's move you up into high cover as well. And we have Jacob DeWitt. Only 3 HP, that's crazy, isn't it? Let's see, let's move you up into high cover over here, I suppose. Need some people spread out, because we have a lot of people. Alright, we know for a fact there's nothing inside of this house, so what we can probably do is move some people up over here. Then Rose Hunter, oh, who was this, by the way? Let's select you again, what was your name? Molly Hill. And then we have Rose Hunter. Rose Hunter can join you next to the flower pots. Alright. No contact so far. Let's see. Yvonne Sanchez could move up, potentially. But first, let's see. Ben Snyder, let's have you open up the door and have a peek inside. We have some civilians, but they're not much of a threat to us. So you could probably move up next to the couch over here and see if there's anything on the street. And still be safe, relatively speaking. Alright, so still no contact. I guess it will be safe to move you up into high cover then. I hope. Still no contact. Okay, so my character will join you. I would prefer to put myself you know what, let's yeah, I would prefer myself to be in high cover, but then that would end my turn, and I don't want to do that necessarily. So I just want to see if there's anything else that my characters can see that I might want to base my own movement on. Let's see, we can move you up into low cover over here. Apparently you don't have no arms, and that's another of those cosmetic mods, and I don't know why this particular set of arms is invisible, but that's something we are going to have to fix, because that's fairly annoying. We have no turn limit, so actually I just might want to put you in Overwatch. And see, Rose Hunter can move up between dual cover over here as well. You have visible arms, but they're very skinny. Let's see, Overwatch for you. Milena Silienska. Wow, that's a kind of a difficult name. She must be Polish. Alright, so still no contacts over here. I think it will be safe to put you up into high cover over here on the side. I hope. She has a lot of HP though. 7. That seems to be very random. We have some people with 5 HP, we have some people with 3, 4, and only this one with 7 apparently, but that's absolutely crazy. Alright, let's see. Yvonne Sanchez, I want her on the roof. Probably up on cover right there. And this roof position is of limited use, I feel, because from here we cannot see all that far in this direction. But it might be okay later on, I don't know. Let's put another character on the roof. And then she can go inside as well. Let's see, preferably in high cover as well. Let's put you next to the door. We haven't seen anything else. So I feel pretty safe moving everybody else up as well. Let's move my own character into high cover too. Alright, so we have enemy contacts, or sound at least, towards the northwest, I suppose. I think they would be around... Wow, this is a really big building. This looks like an advent... Oh, okay, yeah, so this looks like an advent building, and I think this is where we will have the majority of our contacts. So I need to make sure that most of my characters will be in range. Let's see... Let's have a Sulusiera over here open up the door so that we can move through without a sound. And we think, or I think, yeah, this is high cover, so this is medium or low cover. Let's move you up into high cover. Alright, first contacts. Wow. That is a big group already, isn't it? It's a good thing that we have 8 people. Alright, let's move you up into low cover over here, because we can't do much with this high cover until the mission has properly started. Do we have high cover over here? We would at the bus, I feel, so probably move you up into low cover over here. Rose Hunter can... Actually, yeah, this is high cover. We can't get there on this turn, because we would have to move through somebody's line of sight. That is a terrible idea, so I'm not going to do that one. Let's see, let's move you... Right there, I suppose. Ooh, yeah, that's probably contact with another group, maybe.
These
yeah.
guys make up the bulk of the Advent forces we've dealt with. They're disciplined and well equipped, but their obedience makes them predictable.
Right, Ben Snyder. Let's see. My own character needs to move up as well, and preferably as far as possible without initiating contact. And still, well, there's not a lot of high. There's not a lot of good cover over here, which is really annoying. Let's move you up into high cover, I suppose. Ben Snyder. Really? Well, I need to make sure that you need to go through this area, and then we can move you up into high cover over there, or... Probably, actually, that's where I want to put my own character. I want to keep myself alive for this mission. Let's put you into low cover over here. My own character can move... it's a little bit finicky. Just right there, into high cover. You can go into Overwatch. Oh, actually, I can still do something. Alright, Overwatch for you too then. Molly Hill then, what do we want you to do? Well, once we initiate contact, we have some more high cover over here. I'm going to want to make use of. I suppose, yeah, go into low cover where you can still Overwatch. Yvonne Sanchez, however... Yeah, low cover over here, I guess. And then Molly Hill needs to be in Overwatch.
Roger, I've got my eyes on.
Right, let's see what Advent does. Right, so one of their groups is coming closer. Not entirely sure what the other group is going to be up to. Right, so you have... We could, actually, and we probably should, fall back a little bit. We could... Let's see. You have only a line of sight to these four guys. That's perfect. Same for me. Same for her. Same for her. Jacob DeWitt. Let's see. You can only see this group as well and have no view on this group over there. So probably Yvonne Sanchez does have line of sight to them. So she needs to fall back somewhere where she does not have that line of sight. I guess this spot of cover will be fine. And then Rose Hunter needs to fall back as well. Probably behind the car over here. And now we should... Yeah, now we only have contact with the one group. So that makes me feel a lot safer, actually. Let's see. Most of these people have around 60, 67, 68. Those are fairly good odds, but I think I want to start this off with a grenade, if at all possible. Let's see, we have a flashbang grenade and we have a frag grenade. Frag grenade barely reaches the officer. That is pretty bad. Molly Hill, what can you do? Frag grenade. Ah, that's unfortunate. Yeah, of course you're not going to reach that one. Ben Snyder, sick. That's myself. I need to make sure that somebody... I think what I want to do is start this off with a flashbang grenade. Let's see if the flashbang grenade reaches them. Yes, it does. The drone will not be included in the effect of the flashbang. So we only need to reach these three guys. And we would be able to. That would be a pretty good start, I feel. So let's see. Let's keep you in high cover. And let's have you as the one who throws the flashbang. Everyone else... will be going into Overwatch.
You got it. I'm on it.
And actually, maybe Jacob should move somewhere else as well, because he is in a pretty flankable position. That's definitely not all that good. Actually, you know what? Maybe I'm not going to put him in Overwatch, or... No, he can't reach any place without being spotted and still have a relatively unflankable position. So I'm going to... Maybe, actually... No, I'm going to leave him without a job at the moment. Yvonne Sanchez can go into Overwatch. Jacob DeWitt will have to adjust his position afterwards, I think. Maybe even throw a grenade or something like that. Let's see. Milena, let's start off with flashbanging this group. Hopefully that's going to be a good idea. But at least if we miss our Overwatch shots, these guys will have a terrible time trying to hit us back. So, let's go for it. Flashbang out. They're all disoriented, which is good. Now everybody else can take an Overwatch shot. It was going to be like six shots on three guys, or four guys actually. Ah, goddammit, don't waste a shot on the drone. Right, four damage on the officer, two damage there, five damage, excellent, one damage here. Ooh, the drone is down. We have two loots as well. Oh, excellent. And then we... Well, we killed two people. We killed the officer, we killed the drone. That's great. 24 on that one, 24 on that one. That's not all that great. So these guys could potentially flank me. Though, I guess we can now, safely... Or, no, that's going to trigger the other group as well. I don't feel safe moving up over here. This will trigger the other group. This will trigger the other group probably as well. We have three turns. If we could get to this square in three turns, we would have a big loot drop. That would be really nice. These guys, this guy's flanked. That guy is pretty decent in cover. So I'm going to overwatch this character as well. One of those flanked characters will have to move. Well, now they moved as well, but at least we are going to... Ooh, we get a free shot at their group. Interesting. Sadly, it missed. But at least this group will be harmless on this turn. They will not be able to do anything. Ooh, man. Alright, that's a miss. We need to be careful that this car did not be... Or it was not set on fire, because that's going to be a big problem. Alright, we have one Overwatch. What? You get a free turn? Really? You get a turn on the alien? Oh, that is pretty bad, actually. I did not expect that to happen. Alright, well, we can take a shot at this flanked character who is an Overwatch, so that's a pretty terrible decision on his end, but of course, you know, his aim was going to be bad anyway. We are not going to want to move anyone. But we also want to keep in high cover, so let's maybe see if my own character can take this shot. Oh, nice! 7 damage. Straight off the bat, that's another kill. We are not going to get this loot though. I don't think so, at least. Alright, Rose Hunter is probably going to get flanked on the next turn, so let's move you up into high cover. Or maybe high cover over here would be okay. You could not move up into high cover. Somebody else probably could. Molly Hill is in low cover. She could move up into high cover, so... yeah, definitely going to do that. And of course, make sure that these guys are not a perfect grenade target. So, let's see. We flank another character. An Advent Engineer with a grenade launcher. Yeah, he needs to die. Hopefully. 5! Oh, nice! Excellent, excellent, excellent. Alright, so that Grenadier was a huge threat to my people. And luckily, he got killed straight off the bat. That is really good. Alright, is there anything else? We can have high cover over here with this character if she can reach somewhere else. Nah, not really. Is there anything else that we could flank? No. Alright, Jacob DeWitt. We need somebody. Yvonne Sanchez, Rose Hunter. Yeah, let's move Rose Hunter up into high cover over here. Let's see, we have Jacob DeWitt could move into high cover over there, or Yvonne Sanchez. Actually, Yvonne Sanchez should probably move up because she has pretty terrible shots and she is in low cover as well. Let's see. Really, you have no view from here. Okay, I should have checked. Rose Hunter, what can you do? 39 on the Advent Sentry. The Sentries are pretty bad. Advent Trooper, 24. Alright. Ben Snyder. We have a lot of flashbangs though, so if I move one of my characters up as far as we can, we could probably flashbang the new group as well. Jacob DeWitt, he can move up pretty damn far. This would be a bad choice though, because he would be very flankable in that position. But let's see, what can you do with the flashbang? Can you actually reach? No, you cannot reach them at the moment. But if we move him up, we probably can. Let's see, Jacob DeWitt. She already took her shot and killed someone, so that's good. He is in low cover. We could go into high cover and flashbang this group, and he would probably not be flanked. Yeah, this guy could flank around this way, but then he would be flanked. He might, though, because the Advent are usually pretty ridiculous with that stuff. Yeah, we need to be consistently good at Long War, because Long War will definitely fuck you up. We will need to play at least 120 missions, and we need to keep as many people alive as we possibly can. So, definitely want to get a flashbang off. Rose Hunter is not going to be able to do it. Ben Snyder, nah. No. Jacob DeWitt is going to have to do it. You know what? I feel like going for high cover over here might be okay. Because I'm not entirely sure this going here will actually fix it. This will leave me definitely flanked. Yeah. You know what? Let's take that one chance and see how it works out for us. Flashbang grenade. Let's turn the camera just so we can see what we're doing. God damn it. All these angles are pretty bad. Okay, so this would include everyone. So let's throw out this flashbang. And we really need to make sure that we can have some visible arms on this dude. But really, only these two guys got flashbanged. Really? Well, that sort of sucks. Alright, we cannot flank this guy at the moment, so that's unfortunate. She is in high cover, but she is pretty terrible at aiming. Well, she has a pretty terrible aim at this dude, at least. Let's see, could we maybe throw a grenade on this guy and delete his cover? And then get a free shot with these other people? Yeah, I think, because he's going to be in pretty damn bad cover anyway. Let's move him up, just like there. And let's see if we can grenade his cover. And himself as well. Yes, we can. Excellent. Actually, does this provide cover? Yeah, they could get cover over in this corner as well. So if we can take that cover out as well, that would be perfect. And we can. So, grenade right there. Excellent, that's two damage. He still has cover, but it's low now. So we will have a better shot at him at least. 38, that's okay. 35, that's not too great, but it's not entirely terrible. Alright, so she's in high cover. She can take that shot of 38. And hopefully it's going to hit. Nope. Alright, next shot. She's in high cover as well. 35. Just going to have to go for it? No. Okay. That's the last shot I'm going to waste on him, probably. Rose Hunter. 39 on... it's 39 on everyone, and she does 3 to 5 damage. This could be a kill, but he's just a generic trooper. I kind of want to get either the gunner. The gunner would be a great kill, and the advent sentry. But the advent gunner has more HP as well, so that's not going to be that great of a chance. So, you know what? I think the advent sentry will probably be the best choice here. Unless, yeah, I don't know. Because the advent sentry is going to go into Overwatch after his move. If, no matter what he does, he will always be in Overwatch. And well, he's in high cover, so that's pretty damn bad. Actually, you know what? Let's see if we can get a kill on this Overwatch guy. Because if we only do 3 damage on the sentry, we will still have to deal with him later. This will definitely be a kill if we hit, but we did not. Okay, unfortunate. Two of these people are flanked at least, but now, well, Yvonne Sanchez, she doesn't have a really great position that we can take advantage of. We could maybe get high cover over here. This could be excellent. Actually, you know what? Can we be spotted from over here? Yes, we could. Okay. Let's move you up into high cover over here and maybe get you onto the high ground on the next turn. That would be really cool. Alright, I'm not entirely sure what he is going to do. But, he is disoriented. Great. Hopefully, these are all going to be terrible shots. Oh yeah, there is a flank. I knew that this was probably going to happen. Right, so we negated some of the damage, but he is wounded. This is not a flank, is it? No. He's in Overwatch. This is... oh, a miss. 3% to hit. Wow. That flashbang did a really good job on keeping this guy out of the fight. And then we have the... Alright, so that's a miss. That was 5%. Oh, 5% as well. And then he has an Overwatch. Their Overwatch shots are probably going to be pretty damn bad too, though. Alright, so we need to make sure that we can get rid of some... ooh, 75%. And she's still on high cover, so let's take this shot. 4 damage, and that kills him. Excellent. Ooh, and we need to make sure that we can get this... if we could get that stuff over here... that would be really, really damn good, but I'm not entirely sure we can actually pull that off. We could get one of it, but we would leave ourselves in a horrible, horrible position to be flanked later on. So, not entirely sure we want to risk that one. Let's see, this is the only character who is still on Overwatch, so he definitely needs to go. He is, however, pretty damn hard to hit by the looks of it, so I think... this would be a good opportunity to throw another grenade with Molly Hill, probably, because she is in high cover. So, she's in a good position. She's in a safe position. Let's flashbang this dude. Or, grenade this dude, actually. Not flashbang him. Right, 2 damage, he's dead. His Overwatch is removed, as he is removed from the board entirely. Now we need to see if we can get my character, Yvonne Sanchez, up on the high cover over here. Well, we can, but not in a position where we can actually take a shot. At least we can't take one from over here. No, we cannot. And we can't reach the entire way. That's unfortunate. But we could set ourselves up for the next turn, though. Everywhere else, these guys might run to flank her. They're going to expose themselves to a flank as well. So I think that's a pretty safe choice. Let's move Yvonne Sanchez up onto the high ground. Then myself, actually I should probably need to move up as well, because I don't have a shot back here. Jacob DeWitt, 43, 43, these guys are probably going to lose their effect on the next turn. Oh, there's a turn on the flashbang, right? We can use it again, really? 2-turn cooldown. We lost 1 turn. Same for the grenade. Really? Can we use these things over and over again? No, this says only 1 time, right? So that wouldn't make any sense to me, but maybe that's the case.
Order's confirmed. Moving out.
Anyway, let's move Milena up and see if we can get a shot. 38, yeah, it's okay. 38 on the... Let's take it on the sentry. Unfortunate. We still have a lot of shots left, though. We need to move you up. There's no high cover to move you into, unfortunately, but... or actually, I could move you up. If you're going to be in low cover anyway, I might as well put him into low cover over here and at least get one of these loot things, right? Or maybe that's a grenade. Yeah, it's a flashbang. We could get a grenade on one of these guys. Oh, yeah, okay, I'm taking this one. Definitely taking that one. Grenade on all of these guys and destroy their cover. Most likely. No, we did not destroy their cover. Alright, unfortunate, but let's see, what else do we have? We have Ben Snyder over here. Ben Snyder could move up and potentially take a shot, right? Yeah, he could take a shot from over here. We could take a shot from down here as well, but the closer the better. So let's move him up. These are probably the last aliens too. Let's see, 32, 32. Let's take a shot at the gunner, I suppose. If it hits, that would be great, but yeah, not likely. They're both at 2 HP. Actually, one grenade would finish this off. He cannot do it, though. Sudashira, she can probably not do it either. Jacob DeWitt, it's not possible for him to do it. Oh man, I so wish that I could... If this was one tile more, I could have both of these loot things. That would be so, so good. But yeah, you have a flanked shot at the advent gunner, so I guess from high cover he's going to have to take this shot. Has a moral duty to do so. Yes, good. Another advent bites the dust. Alright then, we have our final character over here, which does need to move up to be able to shoot, but yeah, that's never going to work out. Let's move you up into low cover over here and see if we can take this shot. 35%, yeah, I don't know, he's not flanked, so he's probably okay taking a shot from here, but you know what? Yeah, Overwatch will be fine. Disorientation removed, that's unfortunate. He's taking the shot, misses. 44, that's okay, that was pretty pretty good chance to hit my character, but fortunately it failed, and then he went into Overwatch, right. Sadly, we did not get to this loot. It was a chance to get it, but I did not feel entirely comfortable with it. Let's see, 47% from up here, let's take that shot. Nice, alright, he's dead. And I think that's the last advent, which means we can get this loot. Oh, he's not the last advent. Really? Alright, well, I'm glad I didn't waste another grenade on him then. Let's see, let's have Jacob DeWitt grab this loot at least. And see what we get. Expanded magazine. Alright. That's good. Then you can, I guess, move back into high cover. Ben Snyder can reload. And Overwatch, and I think that's what I'm going to do with most of my characters now. It's just going to reload and Overwatch. Milena could probably, yeah, no, I could move her up, but I'm just going to reload and Overwatch. She needs to reload and Overwatch because we're not on a turn timer, right? I'm just going to use this turn to make sure everybody else is ready for the next engagement. She definitely needs to reload with her skinny arms. Alright, we can probably move her up as well, because she doesn't really have a great position over here, so let's move you up into low cover.
Order's confirmed. Moving out.
Please don't tell me that... No, okay. For a second there, I thought we triggered another group, because it usually... When you trigger a new group, you see a little bit of a frame drop, which is really, really annoying, but I can't seem to get rid of it. Alright, she needs to reload, and... Overwatch, then I'm not entirely sure where to go from here. Let's see. There's probably going to be people inside of this building, because it's pretty damn big. And it's an Advent headquarters. So, more than likely, there's going to be someone here. Let's see. Move you up into high cover, I suppose. Definitely need to move myself up into high cover as well. I want to keep myself alive for this playthrough. Alright, Milena. I guess you can move up into high cover over here. I need to consolidate my troops a little bit, so all of these characters can move up into high cover as much as possible. Jacob DeWitt, he needs to reload. It's unfortunate I don't have a med pack at the moment. Alright, you, good sir, can move right there, I guess. And then Molly Hill needs to move up right there, I guess. That's going to be fine. Ben Snyder needs to be in Overwatch. And myself as well. And Rose Hunter is left, so she needs to move up. Let's move you up into high cover over here. What's happening here? That sounds like a sectoid. There's definitely a sectoid up there. And they reanimated a zombie.
The aliens have found a way to mind control them now.
Alright, so the sectoid is over there somewhere, but first let's take care of this zombie. Let's take a shot from up high with 77%. 2 damage. Oh, this was a graze, right?
That won't do it.
That's okay, I suppose. Let's see, Milena, 80% chance, yeah. Let's take that one. 3 damage. So we need one more hit. One more hit would do it. Ben Snyder, 72, yep. Nice, alright. I don't think he can actually revive another alien on this turn. So let's see, Jacob DeWitt, what can we do with you? You could move up into high cover and you would expose the sectoid, but the sectoid is probably not going to be alone. So, not entirely sure. Yeah, he would be in high cover. We can move another character into high cover over there, I suppose. We have Rose Hunter, who can move up into high cover over here. That would be 2 guys in high cover. Yeah, okay. You know what? Let's go for it. I need to get these aliens anyway. There we go. We have a sectoid and what looks like a regular trooper. Right, so he's in high cover. This guy is going to be flanked, most likely. Alright, he's next to a car as well, so this is a perfect opportunity for me to use a grenade. Maybe destroy this cover, and if not, we are definitely going to blow up the car on the next turn. So this guy is going to have to move, and he's probably going to run into a lot of Overwatch fire. Oh wow, it exploded right away. Excellent! Alright, well, I cannot definitely not complain about that one. Let's see, Jacob DeWitt needs to move up into high cover. He's pretty damn damaged, but... Ooh, 24... Let's see... Who else is left? We have Molly Hill, we have myself and Sula Sierra over here. We cannot move into a position where this guy is going to be flanked, probably. Or actually, can we see him from over here? No, we can't. Right, the car exploded. Right, so is there anywhere else with high cover? No. Not by the looks of it. Alright, well, first let's have my character move up into high cover over here, I suppose. And then she can move into a flanking position. Can she actually see him from over here? No. That is unfortunate. Alright, so he could be flanked from over here. That's good. So let's move up one of my characters into a flank position. And Jacob DeWitt needs to be in Overwatch. And let's see, Molly Hill, can we get you in a position? No. That's pretty terrible. Alright, let's move you up into high cover over here then, I suppose. Then Jacob DeWitt, Overwatch. And the same for myself, because hopefully he's going to cross my line of sight too. Right, so there's the first Overwatch shot. It's a miss. We can't get the second one, and he's in high cover. Ooh, man. Okay, 11%. That's pretty okay. very survivable. Is this thing going to explode again? No. Cool. Alright, let's see, my character... if I move you over here, could you be flanked on the next turn? Maybe. Maybe not. I'm going to go for it. I'm going to move this character over onto the high ground again. Maybe we can get a really nice shot on the next turn. Let's see. My character needs to move up, but there's no real great positions over here. This cover is destroyed, so definitely very useless. High cover over here. Alright, let's go for the high cover. You have a flashbang or a frag grenade left. You're not... Ooh, you could maybe blow up that cover. I hope. But we're going to see. Not entirely sure. A slow cover. Don't want that. We need to be in high cover. You don't have line of sight right now, but you can have line of sight from over there, so... Let's see, 24. Ben Snyder, you can move up into low cover.
Interesting.
My own character needs to move up into high cover over here. Just going to go for a few sprints to get more good shots later on, basically. Let's see, you need to be... You know what, let's move you up into high cover over here. And she needs to move up. You can get a shot from over here, so that's good. Let's see if we can blow up his cover. That seems very unlikely, though. It is red, so it should be affected, and I don't know if this is like such a great object that's going to stay put or going to be halved. I'm not entirely sure, but I might as well try, right? Really? Yeah, that did nothing. 20%. Alright, let's hunker down yourself. I need to be in better cover than this. You need to move up into high cover over here as well. I guess you can go into Overwatch. Everyone that's in high cover can go into Overwatch, and the people in low cover need to... Oh, okay. He's not doing much. Ben Snyder, do you have a... Yeah, you have a flashbang grenade left. That would take care of his Overwatch. So let's flashbang him. Cool. Alright, so then we need to make sure that we move up on his flank. Oh, we have high cover over here. So let's take that high cover. This is going to be the last guy, most likely. So, oh, we only have the flashbang grenade left, really. Milena can only move up into low cover unless we sprint. That's going to have to do. Rose Hunter, what can you do? Not much. See, Jacob DeWitt, you could move over into high cover, but that's probably going to get you flanked on the next turn. Unless we move you inside. Yeah, let's move you inside. I feel pretty safe. This looks like the advanced security room. No. Right, Overwatch for you, I suppose. Rose Hunter, what do you have? You have a flashbang grenade. He has already flashbanged though, so that's not going to be any use. She has a grenade. And we have low cover over here, so let's move you up and throw a grenade. And see if this does take care of his cover. I hope. Nope. Oh, but it did 5 damage! Holy shit! Excellent. Alright, so we killed 11 aliens on the first mission and we had only one wounded, so this was a great, great start. Alright, so we also have a mod to have a little bit more varied exit or overview or debrief, I guess, debrief statistics. So we have Killstealer, Yvonne Sanchez, Heavy Hitter, myself, made most attacks, Milena Silienska. Sialinska, I guess, yeah. Lost being a turtle. That's Sula Sierra over here. Mrs. Murray. Most on the fire, Jacob DeWitt. Yeah, he got hurt, so... Overqualified, Molly Hill. Not entirely sure what that actually means. Homewrecker, Rose Hunter, because she blew up a lot of cover, I suppose. And then we have Mr. Congeniality, Ben Snyder. I have no idea what that actually means. But I guess it's good. It sounds pretty good. Alright, that's done. We are back at the Avenger.
We're taking Advent apart one mission at a time, Commander.
Oh!
Impressive work.
Nobody's wounded. Everybody's active. And all ready for promotion. Oh, there's some people standing on the background there because there's not enough space for everyone. Crazy, isn't it? Alright, so, Silianska, what are you? She has a hidden ability. That's another mod I've got activated that gives people, like, hidden abilities. So, in this case, she is afraid of aliens. Gaining a debuff to hitting alien targets, that is really bad. And she is a sharpshooter, so that's really damn bad, because our sharpshooter should be the one getting better shots at these people. And now she will have a debuff trying to hit any aliens she comes across, and we will meet many aliens. Alright, so she's going to be okay at killing Advent, but a little less so at aliens. Let's see for Snyder. He is a small town person. He has gotten used to living in rural areas, making them most at ease at anywhere close to the outdoors like small towns or the wilderness, providing them a randomized buff to stats when deployed in those areas. He is a grenadier, which means he can launch grenades. Excellent. Rookie Sanchez. City person. Okay, so we have an outdoor person and we have a city person. She is an assault class with the run and gun ability. Excellent. Rookie Hunter. Endurance Runner. This soldier is geared for running distances efficiently, gaining an additional movement point, but losing out on mobility per point. Huh. Not entirely sure how that works, but I guess we will notice this in gameplay later on. She is a gunner with area suppression. Fire a barrage that pins down multiple targets within a 4-tile radius, granting reaction fire against anyone that moves, and imposing a minus 30 penalty to all targets aim until suppression is removed and cannot be used when concealed. Right, cool. Soldier ability. She is a knife fighter. You may make a melee attack with your knife against adjacent enemies. She has suppression, area suppression, and of course she was the endurance runner. Myself? Machine Killer. Confidence that they can best any mechanical menace thrown at them has given this soldier a boost in hit chances against mechanical targets. Excellent. I am a ranger. Ooh, cool. I like the ranger class, but this because this means I can get two shots if I stay in one place. So taking a standard shot with your primary weapon as your first action no longer ends your turn. Cool. I get point blank. Fire your sawed-off shotgun at a nearby enemy. I get a shotgun too? Both barrels. Fire both barrels of sawed-off shotgun at nearby enemy, doing double damage. Holy shit. Light them up. Because I am carrying a rifle, right? Or I have the shotgun on my back. That is fucking awesome. And I am the machine killer. Alright, excellent. And then we have Rookie Bazu. She likes being in a squad filled with men. Alright. Well, we can make that happen, probably. And she is a technical. Heavy weapons. This soldier is trained to use the XCOM gauntlet, a combination rocket launcher and flamethrower. This is the new class for the Long War 2 mod. So that's really cool. Let's see. She has it on her left arm. Yeah. Okay, cool. Heavy weapons. Really, really cool. I'm not entirely sure what her abilities are going to be, but we can see that in another video. Let's see. Oh, we have two more people. So we... Oh, Rookie DeWitt. He is wounded for 28 days. Right. I knew that had to happen sometime. Alright, so he is a friend maker. The soldier believes part of the path to victory is encouraging everybody to know each other, increasing the squad mate scores on every mission deployment. He is a specialist with the ability to hack. Alright, so he has 8 protocol, haywire protocol, hack. All of these things are from the base game, and he is a friend maker. We need to make sure he has arms, though. And then we have Rookie Hill. Advent Killer. Confidence that they can best any Advent grunt has given this soldier a boost in hit chances against Advent. That's good. And she is a Shinobi. Shinobi is one of my favorite classes from the Long War mod as well. Slash, attack an adjacent target with your sword, uses one action. But of course that's not all we get. She has Phantom. When the squad is revealed, the soldier remains concealed. That can be a curse and a blessing, all in one. She has Flash, which is a fucking great attack. I use it all the time. Slash, and Advent Killer. Alright, cool. Alright, so we get an expanded magazine and a bunch of corpses. We get some supplies too. Interesting. Some Illyrium crystals. Not entirely sure where they come from. Some alien alloys. And a bunch of corpses, like I said. Doesn't seem like the sectoid is in here. Huh. We have an Advent officer corpse. We have 5 trooper corpses, but no sectoid. Interesting. Alright, let's continue. Soldier Shaken, Jacob DeWitt. He is the guy that got wounded, so I guess that makes sense. Alright, we have to go to research.
Impressive, isn't it? Capable of generating immense power, yet completely harmless to human life. If only the same could be said for the rest of the aliens' technology, Commander. Dr. Richard Tigan, Chief Science Officer. I am responsible for the entirety of our research here, as well as the procedure you so recently underwent. Welcome to my lab, such as it is. I'm not sure what Central may have told you, but we found something while removing you from the alien stasis suit. A device implanted directly in your occipital lobe. Had I access to the equipment available to me during my tenure at Advent, I would already know the precise nature of its function. However, given time and your approval, of course, Commander, I assure you, I will find out. Which brings to light an additional point. Though aspects of this facility are indeed impressive, I am but one man. Were you to direct additional support personnel and resources to me, I could substantially improve the speed of all our research. Farewell, Commander.
Alright, so yeah, I'm going to be going through all of these cutscenes. If you don't want to watch them because you already did so, feel free to skip ahead, of course. Let's see, new research. We have a bunch of new things. So we have the resistance communications, which is the default one, I think. We know there are isolated pockets of resistance around the world just waiting for someone to reach out and organize them. To unite the resistance and forge a global movement, we'll need a means of communication that is both secure and discreet. We have modular weapons, which is from the base game, alien biotech, basic research. Rather than pursue a specific project, we can spend a period of time focusing on improving our theoretical understanding of alien technologies and the previously unknown physical laws that they imply. It will not be a brief effort, but when finished, we will be more efficient in our future research efforts. This is a project we can repeat multiple times. Ooh, that is really cool. And then engineering research. Our team can set aside specific goals to pursue general improvements in our overall ability to develop, test, and manufacture hardware here on the Avenger. It will take some time, but when finished, Shen and her team should be able to do more with less. This is a project we can repeat multiple times. Then we have hybrid materials, but we don't have the alloys to research this. So this is kind of exciting because it takes a long time to research, right? But this means that you don't necessarily need to find scientists or engineers to improve the speed of research or building things. Researching this will actually give you a little boost towards that. So that is really cool. But for now, I'm going to start off with alien biotech because that leads to the Advanced Warfare Center, which is basically a medic station. And we are going to need it in Long War, I feel. Right, so, research. We have to go to engineering as well.
Okay, reworked your repulsors with some of the parts I salvaged from your old engine. Should fix that stabilization problem you had. Come on, Rover. It'll work. Commander! Getting our tech to talk to theirs is harder than you'd think. Lily Shen, Chief Engineer, at your service. You were probably expecting to see my father. In all that's happened, I'm guessing Central didn't tell you yet. He's gone. Dad gave everything he had to get us this far. This entire ship is his life's work. I know he would have loved to show you around the place himself. He used to talk about you a lot. You can be sure I'm ready to finish what he started. Might not look it, but from here, I can fabricate pretty much anything you come up with. And with a little more help, well, you'd be amazed with what I can do. It was an honor to finally meet you, Commander.
Alright, so let's see, build items, we have a little bit of money. We have nothing that we can build, however. Interesting.
Incoming transmission.
Build facilities. Empty build, let's see, we have laboratories, workshop, power relay, advanced... Really? The Advanced Warfare Center is available right from the start. We have a guerrilla tactics school as well. You know what? Fuck it. I am going to go for this facility straight off the bat then. And actually, this changes what we might want to do with research. Change research. Let's change this to resistance communications, because this is going to be important for the storyline, right? So let's go research that instead. Then for engineering, let's see, build facilities. It is going to be up in the corner over here. Advanced Warfare Center. Of course, it's going to take 14 days. We can speed it up with engineer when we get one, but we don't have one at the moment. So, okay, right? We don't have any engineers. Okay, let's go to the command center.
Hello, Commander. The Council you once knew is no more. Its membership have all sworn loyalty to the Advent Administration, with one exception. It is good to see you again. In the days since your capture, I have done all I can to aid the resistance from the inside. It was these resistance operatives that provided the intel leading to your recent extraction. As of now, resistance forces are currently somewhat disorganized. If we are to defeat Advent and their alien masters, you must change this before it is too late.
All right. Resistance management. Let's see. West Asia. So I guess that's where we are. Global resistance threat is low. We have 29 legions for the Advent. Okay, that's really cool. We have a lot of information here. Let's see, global advent strength 29 legions, global resistance threat low, advent strength is 1 in West Asia. I'm not entirely sure what all of these things mean at the moment though. We have a S2, I2, R2, HO. I guess this will all become apparent later on. Let's see, adventure report, objectives, liberate region from advent control. Alright. Adventure XCOM archives. So this is where we will read more about XCOM 2 or the Longwar mod, I think. So let's have a look. Tactical console. Yeah, carrying bodies, concealment, evac, loot, Overwatch. We have all of the classes described in here as well. And here we have the Longwar 2 concepts on resistance and infiltration. Right, so Haven Management. In Long War 2, the commander will take over management of the worldwide resistance movement against the Advent Administration. In regions XCOM has made contact with, you will use the Haven Management screen to direct the priorities of resistance cells. Individual resistance members will be listed on the screen. Resistance members can be assigned to one of four tasks: supply, recruit, intel, or hiding. Okay, so I guess that's where the S, R, I, and H come from that we just saw. Note that rebels assigned to new jobs will not begin work until the following day. Okay, supply job. Okay, so this is all the jobs you can do. So intel gathers us intel, recruitment gives us more troopers, I guess. Let's see, recruits may either join the local haven, or if they have potential as an XCOM trooper, they will enter the pool of potential recruits for soldier training. More rebels assigned to the recruit job will mean faster recruiting of both resistance members and soldiers. If recruited in a liberated region, you have a small chance to find a scientist or engineer willing to work for XCOM. Ah, okay. Supply job, well, this is basically self-sufficient. Intel as well, I think. Hiding job. Who are put in the hiding job will produce no resources, but they will also avoid any unwanted attention from Advent. Busy havens are more likely to attract Advent retaliatory strikes. So putting rebels on the hiding job will lower the haven's profile. Haven operating capacity. Each haven only has a capacity for maximum of 13 resistance members at that haven to be assigned to the supply, recruit, or intel jobs. The rest will be treated as reserves and put in the hiding job. Okay. Advent reprisals. I think it's important to read through this so that we know what we're doing. So if you don't want to read through all of this, you can skip ahead for this as well, because this is going to take a little bit of time, I think. But this is very important stuff, because these things are all changed, and that will definitely play into what we are going to do on the strategic level. So, Advent reprisals. In retaliations and similar missions, resistance members will appear during tactical combat. Depending on the operation, they may sometimes be armed, although they will be less effective than XCOM soldiers in combat. XCOM soldiers are also sometimes required to activate a resistance member by moving close to them, giving the player control of their actions so they can move to escape areas as necessary. In addition, XCOM can recover certain advent assets and repurpose them for Haven defense, granting them additional units to assist in combat. Okay, resistance promotions. Over time, resistance members can become better at their jobs. Resistance members who have gained a level will be marked with an asterisk on the Haven management screen. Expert members who have gained a second level will be marked with an additional asterisk. These promoted rebels will produce more results on any job they are assigned to, and they will also receive XCOM perks for use in combat. That is really cool. XCOM advisors. XCOM may assign a single advisor from its staff to each Haven to assist in various tasks. The advisor may be assigned by clicking the photo frame in the top left of the Haven management screen. Assigning an engineer will generate bonuses for the supply job in the region. Assigning a scientist will generate bonuses to the intel job, and assigning a soldier will generate bonuses to the recruit job. The soldier will also appear on combat missions involving Haven personnel. Cool. The soldier will also hunt for any advent infiltrators in the Haven. Oh, okay. Higher ranking soldiers will generate more bonuses. The soldier should be outfitted with gear on the adventure before departing for the Haven. If a resistance Haven is entirely wiped out by enemy action, the only way to recruit new rebels is to station a soldier in the region. Okay. Advisors may be unassigned from the Haven by clicking on their portrait as long as Advent doesn't have any active reprisals against the resistance underway in the region. Alright, infiltration summary. Many of XCOM's offensive operations require infiltration of the target site over a period of several days. Infiltrating a mission site represents XCOM forces concealing themselves from advent patrols and gathering intelligence on enemy activities. This careful preparation allows XCOM to strike when the time is right. During infiltrations, the XCOM forces will not be available for other missions unless you abort the infiltration and return the troops to base, cancelling any progress you have made. XCOM may have multiple infiltrations underway at once. Properly infiltrating these sites is crucial to conducting missions that XCOM can win. Okay, so that's something that's entirely new and apparently also extremely important. So, yeah, definitely have to check this out. Infiltration missions. These missions use an infiltration start button at the top center of the squad select screen. After selecting your squad and beginning an infiltration, the mission pin on the geoscape will show a percent infiltrated value ranging from 0 to 200%. The more the squad infiltrates a site, the fewer enemy units it will face on the mission. This is the critical role infiltration plays in Long War 2. Ah, that's really cool. So you can make very hard missions a little bit easier. See infiltration progress. While it is possible to launch an attack on many of these sites immediately, the squad could face 2 to 3 times as many enemies without properly preparing for the mission. That would be very bad. And the amount of extra forces is indicated by the enemy readiness description in the infiltration options panel, which can be impregnable, fortified, alerted, guarded, normal, and vulnerable. These are invisible gradations within these categories, or there are invisible gradations within these categories, so every additional hour spent infiltrating makes it more likely XCOM will face a lesser enemy force. More time spent infiltrating also reduces the time the Sky Ranger takes to arrive when the squad throws an evac flare. Ah, so that takes time now too. Calling the Sky Ranger to get out of a mission before it's actually over takes time now. That is a very important change, and I'm happy I'm aware of it. Let's see, note that some critical missions require at least 100% infiltration before the mission may be launched. Okay, so those will be all story related, I suppose. Enemy activity. The impact on enemy forces is also noted in the current and baseline enemy activity readouts in Squad Select and the infiltration panels. These descriptions, such as light, heavy, or swarming, indicate how many enemies you are likely to face, not counting any reinforcements the aliens are able to summon. The baseline enemy activity description, reported when the mission is first detected and in the squad selection screen, represents the expected enemy force level if you infiltrate to 100%. The current enemy activity level is what it would be if you launched the mission at that moment. You can gain... You can gain further bonuses by infiltrating to 200%, although no mission will drop below extremely light activity. And the benefits accumulate much more slowly after exceeding 100%. Okay. boosting infiltration. Oh, you can boost them as well. The commander may also assist in infiltration by electing to spend some of XCOM's intel resource. Using the boost infiltration button in the infiltration options panel will give you the option of spending. Okay. Mentioning infiltration time, the commander has some control over the amount of time it takes to infiltrate the mission site by using smaller or larger squads and by selecting certain soldier perks and gear. This is represented by information presented in the squad select screen. The base infiltration value is how many days a typical XCOM squad of 5 soldiers will take to infiltrate the site to 100%. The squad size modifier value is the impact of the currently selected squad size. The stealth modifier is the impact of abilities and gear. Certain perks, particularly infiltrator and tradecraft, lower infiltration time. Units carrying submachine guns and certain other specialized stealth gear can further lower it. Meanwhile, heavy weapons, specialists, gunners, grenadiers, and technicals will increase the time. Okay, mission expiration. Many missions also expire. Okay. The time left until expiration is noted in the mission expiration value in the squad select screen. The earlier the local resistance haven's intel section detects an enemy operation, the more time XCOM will have until the mission expires. This will often prevent squads from reaching 100% infiltration. Right. When a mission... even when you're infiltrating for a mission, you can still end. Wow. When a mission is expiring on the geoescape, an alert will give the commander the choice of going in at the current infiltration level or aborting. Alright, cool. So that's a lot of information right there. Let's go to the geoescape.
Commander, good to see you on your feet again. Welcome to the bridge, the nerve center of our operation. The aliens have our entire world in their grip. Advent controls everything. Government, communications, industry. Not to mention the military. And it's on us to take it all back. Resources and time are tight, Commander. It'll be up to you to decide how to best use both. The ship is yours.
Alright, we have a black marker that we can investigate. For now, I'm going to ignore it. So we start off with just the one area. We have the Haven in West Asia. Advent strength is 1. We have 2 people working S, I, R, and H. H is hiding, so we know that now. This is recruiting, this is intelligence, and this is supply. Right. We have the black markets, so that's the only mission that we can do right now. I suggest we are going to go for that immediately. Alright. Black market is done. Let's have a look. We can buy almost nothing. We can buy this stuff for supplies now. Okay, cool. So we could buy troops for 28 supplies. That's pretty cheap, but this is a squaddy. We have the engineer and a scientist for 105 or 135. Previously, this would cost intel. This time around, it costs supplies. So agility, combat awareness, expanded magazine, and a stock. All of these things right now I'm not going to buy. Sell inventory, we don't have a lot to sell. It's also all pretty worthless. So let's go back to the Haven in West Asia. Alright, so for now I guess we can spend some time, or what is this? This is the Haven management screen. Ah, okay, so we can send in a Haven advisor. Do we want to do that? Because we probably have a lot of people. Let's see. Wow. Look at that. That's a pretty damn long list. So we have a lot of people in A squad. I guess we will need to make more squads for other groups. Everybody has too low of a rank though. And the other people who do have a higher rank are all in a squad or wounded. So nothing we can do there right now. I think this will be a nicely balanced group as well, so we can just keep these divided like this. I'm okay with that. And then we're just going to spend some time. Incoming transmission. Ah, we've got a mission straight off the bat. So, Commander, the Resistance Council has a new high-priority mission information. Let's see. View mission. West Asia. Rescue VIP from Advent Vehicle. Find a lead. Okay. Baseline enemy activity. Extremely light. We can get an engineer here. So let's confirm the target site. Oh, we can go in straight away like this. So we see Squaddy Hunter, Squaddy Sanchez, Squaddy Snyder. I noticed this in the playthrough. We have the one squad. It is called Trident at the moment. I'm not entirely sure if I want to send these. I probably want to send other people. So that is probably something I'm going to do in the next video, because this has been going on for quite long enough. Right. So for now, this was the first episode for the Long War 2 mod for XCOM 2. Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video and want to see more of this. And I'll see you guys for whatever video I do next.